If you think Sweden is all about IKEA, H&M and ABBA, you're in for a big surprise. Even though the country doesn't have a large military budget, it is well spent. Sweden, which has been a major player in military technology for many decades, continues its achievements with the Saab Gripen JAS-39E and super stealth Gotland-class submarines. Ah, but these are spoilers for our upcoming episodes. In this episode, we will talk about other Swedish weapons that have earned their time in the spotlight. This weapon has proven its worth numerous times during the Ukrainian war and made its name heard in a category populated by heavyweights such as Javelin and Enlor. It may not be as well known as the RPG-7, but it has achieved a notable presence in popular culture. It has appeared in a number of films, including Terminator Salvation, where John Connor used this one to destroy a disabled hunter-killer. The AT4 is an unguided anti-armor weapon produced by Saab Bofors Dynamics. The name is actually a phonetic spelling of the weapon's caliber, 84mm, as in AT4. This weapon system is effective against light armored combat vehicles, landing craft, helicopters, and aircraft. The AT4 was designed by Förenade Fabriksverken and manufactured in their facility in Zakrisdal, Karlstad, Sweden. Although it was based on the Carl Gustaf 8.4cm recoilless rifle, the AT4 was designed as a disposable weapon built around a reinforced smoothbore fiberglass outer tube. The AT4 was introduced to the US Army in 1982, before being adopted by Sweden. After modifying the weapon's launch tube bumpers, sights, and slings, the US Army adopted AT4 as the lightweight multi-purpose weapon M136. It is used by the US Army and Marines as a short-range anti-tank weapon and has been used in a variety of conflicts, including the Gulf War and the wars in Iraq and Afghanistan. The Swedish Army adopted the Americanized version, but theirs also has a folding hand grip to help steady the AT4 when aiming and firing. Let's take a closer look at the AT4. The AT4 is 40 inches long and weighs around 15 pounds, so it's easy to carry around. It consists of a free-flight, fin-stabilized, rocket-type cartridge packed inside an expendable, one-piece fiberglass-wrapped tube. The round can travel 820 feet in 1 second. The AT4 has different projectiles, including HEAT, AST, ER, HE, HP, and RS. The projectiles are preloaded into the launcher. The anti-tank projectile can pierce up to 16 inches of rolled homogeneous armor. The high explosive projectile can be used against buildings and bunkers, and it can detonate either on impact or with delayed detonation. The HEDP-502 projectile has a penetration depth of up to 6 inches in RHA. The extra penetration ability of the high penetration projectile allows it to pass through 19 inches to 23 inches of RHA. The AST warheads are designed specifically for urban warfare. The AT4 has a maximum effective range of about 1,000 feet and a maximum range of 6,900 feet. The weapon is man-portable and is very easy to use. The launcher is watertight, yeah, making it easy to transport and store. Safe. The AT4 launcher, unlike the M72 series LAW, does not need to be extended before firing. Though AT4 can be used in low-light conditions, the firer must be able to see, identify, and estimate the range to the target. Following the weapon's initial deployment, a reusable night sight bracket was developed and deployed. It enables the use of standard night vision equipment. The weapon has a minimum arming distance of 33 feet, making it more accurate in targeting close-range targets. Even if they are heavily timbered, wooden structures cannot withstand the AT4. Unlike the American Javelin, the AT4 still produces a large backblast that could harm the operator or friendly forces if used in a confined space. To address that fact, a special variant, the AT4CS, or Confined Space version, has been introduced. It reportedly utilizes a saltwater countermass to absorb the backblast and to slow down the pressure wave.
On the way! On the way!
The Carl Gustaf Recoilless Rifle is a highly adaptable, man-portable, anti-tank and anti-structure weapon system produced by Saab Bosfors Dynamics. The Swedish company, Carl Gustaf Studs Ivers Factory, owned by the Swedish government and named after King Carl X Gustaf, was responsible for the design and production of the initial model of this weapon. The royal inspiration for its name is meant to honor the original manufacturer while also alluding to the close relationship between the Swedish throne and the weapons industry. The original Gustav was widely adopted by West European armies as a primary anti-tank weapon for use by squads. The Carl Gustaf M2 replaced the original shortly after its introduction in 1964 due to its superior design. The US Army took an interest in the following M3 model in the early 1990s. Its adoption was initially limited to the Army's Special Operations Command, as the weapon's versatility, lightweight design, and powerful anti-tank and anti-structure capabilities made it an ideal choice for special operations forces. The Carl Gustaf M3 Multi-Role Anti-Armor Anti-Personnel Weapon System, or MORS, quickly gained popularity among US soldiers due to its ease of use, accuracy, and effectiveness against a wide range of targets. Despite its increased weight and cost compared to the AT4, the M3's rifled metal carbon fiber launch tube offers the advantage of reloadability. Utilizing the 22-pound M3 proves more manageable than the 50-pound FGM-148 Javelin. This weapon system allows for faster engagement compared to waiting for mortar support, and it is more cost-effective than the Javelin and artillery shells when targeting enemies in hard cover.
Okay.
In 2011, the US Army decided to expand the use of the Carl Gustaf M3 to its regular infantry units, as the conflicts in Iraq and Afghanistan highlighted the need for a more versatile and portable anti-armor and anti-structure weapon. This decision proved to be highly beneficial, as the Carl Gustaf system's adaptability allowed it to use a range of ammunition types, including high-explosive anti-tank, HEAT, high-explosive dual-purpose, HEDP, and high-explosive HE rounds.
It is also capable of marking threat targets with smoke for supporting weapons, obscuring threat weapons, and illuminating threat targets. The effective range of the weapon fluctuates from approximately 1,150 to 1,310 feet and extends up to 6,600 feet depending on the ammunition type, target type, and particular weapon model being used. The M3 model has undergone several upgrades and modifications since its initial adoption by the US Army. One such upgrade is the M3E1 or M4 variant, which was developed in response to the needs of US soldiers for a lighter, more ergonomic, and safer weapon system. In comparison to the M3, the M4 is 7.5 pounds lighter, weighing 15 pounds, and has a shorter overall length of 37 inches. This reduced length was developed in response to the need for better maneuverability in urban terrain, and the weight savings were accomplished by using lighter components, such as a carbon fiber tube with a titanium liner and a new Venturi design. Additional features include a red dot sight, a travel safety catch for carrying the weapon while loaded, an adjustable shoulder rest and forward grip for enhanced ergonomics, and a shot counter to monitor the number of rounds fired, ensuring proper management of the weapon's 1,000 round barrel life. The M3E1 is saltwater submersible, jumpable, and day and night operable. It requires a crew of two, one to carry and fire the weapon, and the other to carry the ammunition and load the weapon. It can be operated by a single person when necessary. The recoilless system employed in the Carl Gustaf is a special design that significantly reduces the recoil experienced by the user when firing the weapon. To do this, the Carl Gustaf utilizes a pre-engraved rifling on the ammunition, which is a soft metal driving band that engages with the weapon's rifling to seal the bore and reduce gas leakage when the round is fired. This effectively cancels out most of the recoil forces, making the weapon more comfortable to fire and easier to control. The primary trade-off for the recoilless design is the back blast created by the escaping gases, which can pose a danger to personnel or equipment in the vicinity of the weapon when it's fired. The Carl Gustaf recoilless rifle is also famous for being one of the loudest weapons on the battlefield. This concludes our episode that provides a glimpse into the AT4 and Carl Gustaf weapon systems. So, what do you think about these formidable weapon systems? How effective are they? What other pieces of military hardware would you like us to cover in our future episodes? Also, if you were lucky enough to operate one of the weapons mentioned in this video, please comment.
Fire! Fire! Fire!
Fire! Fire! Fire!
Fire. Fire. Fire.
Firing!
Remember to hit the subscribe button and ring that bell to stay updated with our latest content. And while you're here, why not check out another one of our exciting videos? Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.